watching The Daily Left on GoLeft TV. Thanks for joining me. According to top CIA cybersecurity experts, a majority of voting machines are not secure and can easily be hacked. The CIA reports that any voting machine that's connected to the internet can be easily hacked by an outsider, and even though most states have banned the use of Wi-Fi cards in voting machines, a clever hacker could easily install one without it being detected. One expert even said that computerized electoral systems can be manipulated at five stages, from altering voter registration lists to posting results. But this CIA review wasn't the result of the faulty voting machines that plagued Ohio in 2004 or the ones in Florida back in 2000. No, this review was because the CIA was afraid that a foreign country might try and hack into our voting machines and change the outcome of an election. And they wasted no time trying to once again vilify their least favorite South American leader, Hugo Chavez, by claiming that the socialist leader might have actually hacked into and changed the results of this recent election. It's nice to know that our government finally cares about the sanctity of elections and making sure every vote is accurately counted. It's just a shame that they only care about those things when it's other countries they suspect of screwing with votes. Well, in other news, while President Obama was addressing the nation about the biggest issues facing our country earlier this week, several prominent Republicans had more important things to do than worry about our financial crisis. Instead of tuning in to Obama's speech, they were attending a Britney Spears concert. House Republican Eric Cantor confirmed to the blog Wonkette that he was in fact watching the newly revamped Queen of Pop performing at the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. at the same time the president was speaking. In his haste to justify his actions, Cantor's office told the blog, quote, "After attending the NRCC dinner, Eric, like President Obama has been known to do, enjoyed a night at the Verizon Center. It was a bipartisan night as Eric was joined by Senator Landrieu and other Democrats. However, a few hours later, they said that they really couldn't verify that Landrieu had attended the concert, so that just leaves the Republican congressman and a group of alleged mystery Democrats." Just to be clear, in case you missed it, Eric Cantor, the GOP whip in the House of Representatives, blew off the president's address to go to a Britney Spears concert. Nice priorities. That's all for the Daily Left for today. I'm Lee Morris. Thanks for watching Go Left TV, Citizens Media on the Rise.